I wasn't paying attention, my bad.
We kind of figured that
it was like so
and then,
speak any English language, please? I swear to God, you guys are gonna have to.
It looks like a glass water bottle.
Stop. $11 each, but you get like the load them up.
Loaded.
We're kind of worth the $11. This and the footlongs, worth it.
Christian. That's Sofia. Mi primera novia es Linda María. Mi primer amor se llamaba Talía. Tengo una colombiana que me chica todavía. Mi nombre es Fernández, ni yo sabía. Otra se la tengo que me quiera todavía. Y la tuve es que por mi caso mía. Una dominicana Cuba de Barcelona que vino en avión. Y dice que mi bicho está cabrón. Yo dejo que mi corazón.
Where my smokers at? Right to interrupt a lady on her phone. Now I gotta find someone else straggling. Some other straggling smokers. What are the cops looking for anyway? Like people smoking pot? Oh, should we test the theory?
I was the first smoker to come out.
They're like, yeah, we do have a spin and out policy, but you're the first degenerate that asked us, so. Literally everyone else is still flooding in. The show starts in like 50 minutes. I'm sorry, but I've had a king can. And I need my marijuana. Not really, I just want it. I just prefer it. It enhances the experience. See what we can do to get past the dogs. We're gonna smoke two of the joints, so it'll smell even less like pot and be less incriminating once, if we get in shape. I think they're looking for cocaine, though. I'm hoping. So if they're looking for pot, they're doing a real bad job. I've already been in there. Walk by right by their drug dogs. Didn't really see if they could, if they gave a signal, but trying not to be obvious. Just staring at the drug dogs, like That's funny though. Yeah, kind of fun. Beats fucking regular shift out home. Celebration 100. Running and shit. Fuck out of here at your house. Alright, so everybody's in. We managed to get out. Have a little Tokyo. The show's starting right now. Should be starting right now. Look at this. This is a beautiful view. Look at that. Would you look at that? CN Tower. That's the one. CN motherfucking Tower. Without dying. Can you smoke this? Get out of the way. I'm going to be the first and only. Well, definitely the first one. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Inuit.
is the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and the Huron-Wendat nations. We also acknowledge that Toronto is covered by Treaty 13, signed with the Mississaugas of the Credit, and the Williams Treaties, signed with multiple Mississauga and Chippewa bands.
What about World Water Advisors?
World Water, a list of nations of known drinking water.
Go.
At Canadian Tire, our brand purpose is we are here to make life in Canada better. And making life in Canada better requires us to make a conscious commitment to honoring Indigenous peoples and educating ourselves on the truth of Canada's history. I've made a personal commitment to ask questions and seek opportunities to further educate myself on our country's history. I am grateful to be part of an ongoing conversation and learn more from our employees about what we can do, all do, to take meaningful steps towards reconciliation. At CTC, we are especially proud of our partnership with the Gord Downie and Shani Wenjack Fund, an incredible organization building cultural understanding and creating a path towards reconciliation between Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples. With that, I'd like to introduce the Chair of the Board of the Downie Wenjack Fund. He is an esteemed elder of the Mohawk and Ojibwe ancestry who resides on the Six Nations Reserve. Please welcome Mr. Bob Watts.
Okay.
I've just offered a smudge on behalf of all of you and your families and your communities as we gather here tonight to make this place special and sacred, and that this medicine might be healing for each and every one of you and your families and your communities. When we do our invocations or prayers, we offer thanks to all of creation and to the Creator. When I turned to the four directions, I gave thanks for the teachings from those directions. Teachings of vision, patience, knowledge, and action. And for the people who are here from all the directions, Canada is a special place. We benefit from thousands of years of love that Indigenous people have shown for the earth, and that in itself creates sacred space for all of us to live in. I acknowledge how special this land is, that we can live together, even though we come from many great nations and societies scattered around the globe. All of you, no matter where you are from, come from great medicine societies. We can learn to put our medicine together for the benefit of future generations. And we acknowledge and give thanks for this time of harvest that we have been experiencing, that once again, Mother Earth has so generously provided for us. And in return, we are asked to treat her with love and with kindness. As a country, we are on a journey of reconciliation. This journey requires respect, courage, and determination based on a new vision of what's possible. It requires awareness, acknowledgement, atonement, and action. It's significant that Canadian Tire has been on our own journey of reconciliation for some time. The potential impact of all of you professionally and personally is enormous. You are present in every part of Canada, and I invite you to stand shoulder to shoulder with Indigenous peoples across the country in a demonstration of support and jointly writing a future that all of our children and grandchildren and future generations can inherit proudly. This is truly a significant time for the Canadian Tire family. I wish you a bright future and look forward to hearing your stories of reconciliation. Miigwech, Nyawagoa, thank you, merci.
Thank you.
a century to get the party started. She's a Canadian Music Hall of Fame inductee, an eight-time Juno Award-winning singer-songwriter, a best-selling author, and star of her own hit TV show. And she is your host for this evening. Give it up for Jan Arden. Say you're looking good for 100. You really are. It's going to be such an amazing show tonight. We've got music, we've got some great prizes, we've got some very special guests. Among those, we have Blue Rodeo. We've got Michael Bublé. We've got Deborah Cox. And most importantly, we have all of you guys. Because not only is tonight a party to celebrate a century of success for this amazing Canadian company, it's also a celebration of all of you. The people who make Canadian Tire the iconic retailer it has been for 100 years. Now that is something to celebrate. You're going to get so tired of clapping for yourselves, trust me. Okay, go ahead, give yourselves a hand. Come on. A.J. Billis and his brother J.W. had the foresight to build a business around the products that would rule the economy for a century. And we're not talking about my insatiable habit for cool kitchen gadgets. We're talking tires. Yes, tires. And from that spark of inspiration, here we are tonight, celebrating an unprecedented Canadian business legacy. The 100 years of retail innovation has made it one of the most successful businesses in our country's history. It's a brand that is linked to our memories. And it's more than just a company, it's part of our lives, it's part of Canada. For years, Canadians have loved Canadian Tire. Everyone has a Canadian Tire story. Stories about getting their first skates or their first set of jumper cables, yes. They love all the cool things they can find there, and even the smell of the stores. I mean, people go there just to smell the stores and to hang out in the aisles that get you on your way to the cash registers. Canadian Tire, I have such fond memories of it, and I know you're probably thinking it's going to be a sporting goods story for me or fishing. No, my mother's crock pot blew up, and my dad took me to Canadian Tire to get a crock pot. I ate 3,000 meals out of that crock pot. It didn't matter what went into the crock pot, it all came out looking the very same. Thank you, Canadian Tire. There's a Canadian Tire close to my house, and I'm there all the time. In fact, and I don't want to boast, I will just a little bit, I was inducted into the Canadian Hall of Fame a couple of years ago. The next day, you know, you get a nice trophy and it's all great, but the next day I tweeted, as you do, and I just said, you know, you'd think you'd get something actually that meant something, something substantial. The trophy's great, but I wouldn't mind a permanent parking lot at my Canadian Tire. Parking spot, okay, not the whole lot. And somebody from Canadian Tire reached out to me, and I have had my own parking spot at the Richmond Canadian Tire. Celebration of Canadian Tire, and tonight we are going to have the celebration of the century. Along with all the great special guests and prizes, tonight we want to bring the family a little closer together. So we're going to be visiting some of our friends at Canadian Tire stores across the country. And speaking of prizes, I am so thrilled to introduce to you my good friend and co-host who's going to be helping me out tonight. He's an amazing comedian and CBC radio host who's appeared at Just for Laughs and headlined all over Canada. Please say hello to Ali Hassan. Ali, can you hear us up there?
Hello, Jen. I can good time. These people look pretty cool. They look like they know how to party. Do you know how to party? Do you feel? Yes. On the surface, they look like people who just like to eat popcorn. But deep down, these are party animals. And if I haven't made friends yet, I'm about to, because I'm about to give out some prizes. So why don't I start that out? This is something you're going to grow to enjoy. It's throughout this evening. This is the Great Celebration of a Century Trivia Challenge. I have two contestants right here. Please say hello. Say hello to Karen and Flora. Come on up, both of you. You've been handed your horns. How do you feel about that? Ready to play? Ready to enjoy yourselves? Okay, just saving your voices for the big moment, I guess. Yeah, okay. You know that your voices work. You don't need to test the mics. You're okay. Okay. All right. Well, let me let you know how this works. The two of you, I'm going to ask you some trivia. And the first out of the two of you to get two answers correct wins the prize. Okay? That prize is the best seat in the house. You get to move to VIP seating. Yes. I know I said that this area is cool. You are still cool. You are still cool. It's VIP seats. What do you want from me? All right. So, we've been talking about this. Canadian Tire story spans an incredible 10 decades, right? It's been part of our lives throughout the entire century. So let's see who has a grip on Canadian history. Okay. No, I was looking for them to gulp or be scared. No, they seem confident. All right, let's do this. Number one question. Canadian Tire is older than the Canadian flag, which was introduced when the company was already 43 years old. So quickly, without looking at your phones, what year was the Canadian flag officially unveiled? Was it 1955, 1967, or 1965? Okay, whose horn came in quickly? Was that you, Florin?
Guess so, yeah.
Okay, what is your answer?
1965.
1965 is your answer. Karen, what is your answer?
1967.
Love the confidence. It was misguided and ill-advised. It was not the right answer, but I still love the confidence. 1965 is the answer. We've got Florin in the lead right now. Okay, good. No problem. Somebody had to take the lead. Second question. In the opening musical number of the show tonight, we saw the action that was taking place at the garage that the Billis brothers owned, the one that they started selling tires back out of in 1922. So, do you know your Canadian Tire facts? What was the name of the street in Toronto's East End where that garage stood? Was it on Dundas Street, Hamilton Street, or Riverdale Drive? Florin?
Hamilton Street.
He says Hamilton Street. What do you say, Karen?
Hamilton Street.
Hamilton Street as well. The problem is that Florin came in hot with the horn, so he gets that one. Let me just ask you the third question. One final question. What year did Canadians see the very first store with the name Canadian Tire Corporation on it? Was it 1922, 1923, or 1927? Karen?
1923.
And the fact that Florin won, just, it's extra salt in your wounds now, because you could have had it. You could have had it. Guess what? All right, the winner, that is you, Florin. We are moving you up to the best seat in the house. VIP experience for the rest of the night. But I have some good news. This is how Canadian Tire rolls. Everyone is a winner. You're going to the front row, too. You're all going to the front row. Enjoy the rest of the show from your VIP seats. Thank you. Back to you, Jen.
Thank you.
Super cool.
Thank you, Ali. It's fancy down here. I'm telling you, it's fancy. When I think of Canadian Tire, I think about a lot of great things. One of them is camping. Wild young days, going to bush parties or camping trips with my friends, and Canadian Tire was always the supplier of those great times. Getting a cooler, ice packs or a chair, mosquito repellent, or something for your tent, or even your tent.
Yeah.
So when I was thinking of performing tonight, I thought, what could be more Canadian than a Canadian Tire extravaganza and sitting around a campfire playing some great tunes with my friends? So that's what we're going to do. Right here, right now, we're going to create Jan's Fantasy Campfire Set. First, staging team, we can do this. We need a cozy campfire.
Melissa, get up there.
I love this. Now, let's change up the mood a little bit. Vincent, are you here? Can we have a little atmosphere, please? How about a little ambience? Sound guys?